This expo is going to finish tomorrow after 2 weeks, and it's time to assess the results. I could see that there were 3 types of viewers: those who came fast and went running away because they didn't see much, some who stayed long time and look at the big panels, and a few more were interested in the details. And that comes to the, I realized that there is a kind of ambiguity in this work, in the sense that you can see it on a macroscopic way, seeing from far with the environment, or looking in close-up and see the thing. Actually, it is the close-up version which I was looking for, because it relates to an experience I had long time ago, where suddenly, after a very hard experience, I landed into a place of light, beauty, joy, color, music, and I felt I had landed into another country. Before, I knew I was an artist, but I never knew what to paint. After I had this experience, I said, oh, this is what I would like to express. And it took me more than 40 years to try to find a kind of language which will approximate this experience. So what is this technique made of? Because of the space I encountered, I felt the need to use porous material, because the main property of that space was incredible porosity. The second thing is that I wanted to use, because it was a feeling of totality. So for me, one way to relate to totality with colors is to use all the colors. So I decided to use all the colors of the chromatic circle. And then, on top of that, I was looking for a way to put the dots, because that is the main problem when you are painting. When you are painting outside, you paint a landscape or a tree, the nature shows you where to put the paint. But when you are doing in an abstract, what makes you paint at right, left, below, you have no clue. So I found, one day I was looking at a text, a printed text, and I found very interesting the way, if you focus on one single letter in a printed text, let's say the letter E, you see that it comes at a very vibrating place in the page. Then if you take another letter, S, it comes also, and the two network mingle into each other. So from that on, I said, yeah, I should try to use text as a guide to put my colors. Parallelly, I've invented a type, an alphabet, which I've been using since a very long time, which permitted me to use that to put the color. This alphabet is made of letters which are quite porous. So what I do now is superimpose different layers of text, each one with one simple color. And after the 12 superimposition, it happened that the last text is prominent and the very first is almost fainted. Why I've been doing that is because in the experience I had, it was, and which is recurring, it's a moment when you don't think. There is no thinking, there is no emotion, there is no sensation. It is very physical, only physical. So how to find a way to paint in such a new, totally neutral way, totally physical? That's what I've at last succeeded this time. That I paint now is like a game. You put the color according to a predetermined text, and you have no idea what will come out. It's, in a sense, it's very, very conceptual. But if you look at, for example, if you take a match of football, you have a ball, you have 22 people, and there are no football matches are the same. They are always different. So with this technique, which is apparently very constrictive, I can make it, each time it will be different according to the color chosen from the beginning. So this is where I am. And So to come back to the, what I said first, when there was the, so in that sense, you see, you can see this painting, the main thing from far is mainly blue. But if you go closer, you see that there is an incredible richness of dots, and it creates a kind of a vibration. People, there are some people who felt like there was like a dance. So this is what is really the closest to the experience I have. And by changing the order of the colors, I can manage to explore different moods of the being. I would say that reminds me a little the Tibetan banners in the Himalayas. You see, when you see, you are in the landscape, and you see those bright colors dancing in the mountain. And that's the first reading. But you know also that each flag on each flag there is a prayer which is very auspicious. So when they make that, the Tibetans, they believe that they bring a kind of auspicious quality to the spot. So in that sense, I won't say the same, but there is something similar about the first reading of the blue and then the message, so to say, which is inscribed in a thing, hoping that this message will have a beneficial quality on the viewer or the environment. Yes, I said that it's time to assess, so I was trying to see what was the good points of the expo and what was the shortcomings. For example, the people who could dig more the details, they felt the need to stay much longer in a comfortable way, and they felt the need of benches to have time to go deeper. And after, when I look at the expo, it's a very beautiful space, but I believe my work has a more is more conducive to architecture. So ideally, if I could visualize the next step for myself, would be to create an architectural environment, which is a kind of dream, because I don't know if it's possible, but I'm going towards that.